everybody. Welcome to season 11 of the Christy Marie Show. I feel like that it's been a long time. And there's a lot, you know, that's happened. A lot has happened. Season 10 was not supposed to end the way it did. What I mean by that is because, you know, the last episode said to be continued. Well, because of some issues that I was having in my own personal life, if you remember, I mentioned on Facebook that I had quit my Zoloft cold turkey, and I was experiencing some very intrusive thoughts. I don't want to go into depth with it. But anyway, I've started back on my Zoloft. I am doing better. As you may already know, I'm going to be starting some therapy. But anyway, I am doing better. I am doing better. Thank God. It was a really scary time. Really scary. I've never been so scared in my life. But anyway, I know never, ever to quit taking that kind of medicine, cold turkey. I mean, I still had a half a bottle that should have been refilled. And I mean, so it got bad. It got really bad. The panic attacks were terrible. Okay. As you know, my cousin, Ivy, cousin passed away, Ricky. And you remember when, a few years back, bonnets are falling, it's scaring me. A few years back, you know, I did a lot of filming at when Jesse was little, growing up, and he was a part of my show. I mean, you know, I have a lot of videos, you know, of him with Jesse, and everything. Back in 2020, he had a heart attack at age of 40, and he went in for open heart surgery, and so the night that he passed away, and I didn't ever go into detail about what exactly happened, but from my understanding, I mean, you know, from everything that we gather, we think he had a massive heart attack. Thank God Jesse was not there when he passed away. She was in Clinton with her little cousin and her family, and Ricky and Ivy had dropped her off, went to pick up something to eat, they watched a movie, they got a shower, and they were in the bedroom, and he collapsed on the bed. And Ivy tried to give him CPR, you know, because she's in the medical field, if you call it that, but she knows a lot of stuff, so she tried and tried to revive him. The paramedics tried to revive him, but he was gone. And she called me. It happened around 8:26 on July 26th, Friday night. And it's been 2 months. It's been rough. I've been with her every step of the way. I've been over at her house a lot. We've been working on her house, cleaning up some things, and you know, just helping her out as much as I can. She's still having, you know, of course, a hard time, and it's going to be that way for a very long time. Right now she's just not working. Jesse, her daughter, you know, has some things going on. I'm not going to go into detail, but like, she's got ADHD, and she's had some more testing done, and I've been going with Ivy, to to Jacksonville with her, take her to therapy. And so, I mean, I've just been right there, you know, with her through it all. Because she's like my sister, you know, I mean, we grew up together. We're cousins, but we're more like sisters because we're so, so close. And it breaks my heart to see her in so much pain. You know, losing Ricky the way she did. And I know that God has a reason. He always has a plan. And I keep telling her, you know, he knows what he's doing, and he, you know, Ricky was saved. I mean, he was saved. I mean, you know, she said he backslid a little bit, but he was a good man, and God knew his heart. Ricky, you know, had a lot of things. I believe deep down inside of him, you know, you never really know, but God knows, you know, God knows everyone's heart, and I do feel that Ricky is in a better place, and it was just his time, you know. When it's your time, and God is going to take you. When it's your time, I mean, he knows you before you were in the womb of your mother. So, you know. But anyway, we had a lot of fun with Ricky, you know. He was funny. Good, great, great father of Jesse. He loved Ivy and Phoebe and Jesse with all his heart. And we miss him. It's really weird. It still don't feel real at all that he's gone. You know, when someone dies, it's never the same. Never the same. But anyway, so it's just been a rough road. And it will continue to be a rough road for Ivy right now. I mean, you know, you never really get over it. You just have to move on, and you have to, you know, keep moving on because that's what they would want. But, anyway, yeah, it was a sad time, and it's still a sad time, you know. I mean, it's still fresh, you know, it's only been 2 months, and then you got the holidays coming up and everything. So at the end of this video, I'm going to have a tribute to Ricky. I'm going to show some pictures, and I know that, you know, it's going to be emotional, and I've already picked out the pictures. They've been on my phone for a couple months now, and I got to start my show, you know, and let everybody know that, no, I'm not done with it. I can't just be done with it. There's too much that's going to be going on, tonight I'm going to a visitation for a friend that I went to school with, and, I've done some photo shoots for, her family, and I'm sad about that. There's been so many people that I've known of that have passed. I mean, my friend lost her father back in, like, May. Something like that, maybe. Anyway, so I went to his funeral. And then Ricky passed away. Of course, you know, I was there for every bit of that. I was with them when we viewed him. And that's some hard stuff. I mean, it's tough. But anyway, and then I'm going tonight to a visitation for Brenda. So yeah, it's just nothing but the bearer of sad news right now, but things will get better. They always do, as long as you have God and trust in Him, and because He's gotten me through a lot, and He continues to get me through a lot. So we're going to try to switch over to some happy things right now. Well, as you know, I got the ugly old bump removed off my forehead back in August the 1st, that's right. And it seems so good for it to be gone. I'm going to do my hair the way I want to. Mama's doing fine. She's in the house, but you'll see her. And like I said, I was really disappointed that I couldn't end season 10 the way I had wanted it to end. But, sound like a gunshot over there. But I'll just kind of fill you in. Chrissy and Bubba had a wonderful honeymoon. Bubba's working. I think Tom got a job. Tom bought Patty this awesome beach house up there in Moorhead City, I believe. Emerald Isle. Yeah, something like that. Anyway, and so they spent a lot of their time there this summer and everything. Bobo and Chrissy are still looking for a place. Right now, they're in the cabin. Tom is with Margaret. But, you know, I think I haven't really kept up with them much, you know. I thought myself, Lord, they're going to think I've stopped my show. But, I mean, I had it on my mind, you know, with so much going on, maybe I should just take a break from it. But, nah, I can't. Because, I mean, you know, I know how many people out there like it and stuff. And Saturday we're having a benefit ride for Ricky, motorcycle benefit ride, and I'm going to be out there helping with the registration. And since this will be up, well, you're watching this, so it's Thursday. So if you're watching this, and if you want to go out there just to donate some money or whatever, please do. Abby and Jesse could really use it right now. I'm not going to ride a motorcycle because I ride a trike, but I rode a motorcycle one time and they're going to White Lake and back. So I'm actually going to be in the car with Ivy's friend Kim with the flashers on. And I said, well, I want to do something, you know, to be a part of it. So I'm going to be riding with her. I'm looking forward to it. I think it's going to be a nice time. And I'm praying that there'll be a lot of people riding and a lot of people participating in this ride. So, Well, I think that's about it. We've had a wonderful summer. Me and Ivy and Jesse and Mama all went to the beach and stayed the night. And it seemed so good to see Ivy and Jesse so happy, you know, enjoying themselves. And we are wanting to take Jesse to back. Well, Ivy and her mom and Ricky and Jesse all went to the Ashboro Zoo last November for Jesse's birthday. And it was cold and rainy, and they had fun, but they wanted to take Jesse back. And Phoebe said that me and Abby and Jesse could go, and we're wanting to go maybe the end of this month, but we don't know yet. I think that that they're still debating if we're going to go or not, because it's a long ride and a lot of walking, and you know, and with Abby just not working right now and everything, I'm like, you know, we don't know what we're going to do. We may go. And I would like to film, you know, some out there, because I went out there when I was little, like maybe 6 or 7, and it was hot. And that was years ago, of course. And they've changed it a lot. I know there's a lot of walking. Whew, I guess I could do it. I could do it. But anyway, right now, I'm going to go and finish a little bit of mowing I've got to do. It's cloudy and nice and cool out here, and I'm so glad because I'm just really tired of hot weather. Hot weather. So, but I'm not done recording yet. We'll see Mom shortly, and then we'll end it with a trivia trick. So, yeah, this feels good right now. So I'm gonna go, but I'll see y'all in a bit. Bye for now. Well, I'm. It's almost time for me to go to the visitation. I'm gonna go with Nancy and Brenda. Oh boy, there's Mama. Well, there she is.
Yeah, so sugary.
What?
That's pretty to get. You gonna sit out here?
Yeah, because I'm smoking.
I'm gonna lock on up.
Okay.
Let's see if I got lost. I feel like I've missed. I've teed something.
I feel like I forgot. I'm forgetting something too, but I got my bag and my tea. I'm just going on to Bible study. And then after the visitation, we'll have time probably to make it to Bible study. Not prayer meeting, but Bible study and choir and cantata practice. I got my Halloween lights going, but you can't see them yet. I did something different with the bike this year. At night, I'll show them to you. I've got to go to Wilmington tomorrow with Ivy to take Jessie for her biopsy results to see if she's got a gluten allergy, and we're praying to God that she don't. Okay. I'm gonna go for right now. Bye for now. Hey everybody. I'm sorry I didn't get a chance to finish recording. But I had to leave to go to the visitation. So, anyway, I'm gonna go. And like I said, I'm gonna end this video with a tribute to Ricky, and I hope everybody enjoys it. Always keep Ivy and Jesse in your prayers. They really need it because, you know, Ivy's, you know, still having some really bad days, which is to be expected. Anyway, I'll see everybody later. Oh, I guess Sheila wants to say bye too. Bye for now.
A bright sunrise will contradict the heavy fall that weighs you down. In spite of all the funeral songs, the birds will make their joyful sounds. You wonder why the earth still moves. You wonder how you carry on. But you'll be okay on that first day when I'm gone. Dusk will come with fireflies and whippoorwill and crickets call, and every star will take its place in silvery gown and purple shawl. Dread the dark and dread. on that first night when I'm gone. Life will call with daffodils and morning glorious blue skies. You'll think of me, some memory, and softly smile.